I welcome you all to this program, Voice of Saints. Today, our Holy Catholic Church celebrates the feast of Saint Catherine of Siena. Catherine, the daughter of a humble Christian tradesman, was raised up to be the guide and guardian of the Church in one of the darkest periods of history, the 14th century. As a child, prayer was a delight. She would say the Hail Mary on each step as she mounted the stairs and was granted in reward a vision of Christ in glory. And he revealed to her the secrets of Christian perfection. When only 7 years old, she made a vow of virginity, afterwards enduring bitter persecution for refusing to marry. Her parents persisted long in the refusal to allow her to enter religious life, her only ambition, but she made a kind of spiritual and penitential convent cell in her heart's depths, as there she found her beloved and conversed with him each day. At the age of 15, she was permitted to enter the Third Order of Saint Dominic, but continued to reside in her father's house, where she united a life of active charity to the prayer of a contemplative saint. Our beloved bestowed on her a first heart in exchange for her own, gave a communion with his own hands, and imprinted her on the body on the marks of his wounds. From this obscure home, the Seraphic Virgin was taken by Providence to defend the Church's cause. Her life became a continuing miracle. Armed with papal authority and accompanied by 3 confessionals, she traveled through Italy, reducing rebellious cities to the obedience of the Holy See and winning hardened souls to God. In the sight of virtually the whole world, she sought out George XI at Avignon, brought him back to Rome, and by her letters to the kings and queens of Europe, made good at the papal cause. She was the counselor of Urban VI and sternly rebuked the disloyal cardinals who took part in electing an anti-pope. Long had the Holy Virgin foretold the terrible schism which began before she died. Day and night she wept and prayed for unity and peace. But in spirit, she saw the entire city of Rome full of demons who were tempting the people to revolt and even slay the vicar of Christ. With intense earnestness, Saint Catherine begged the Holy Lord to prevent this enormous crime. Their seditious temper was subdued by her prayers, but then vented their rage by scourging the saint herself, who gladly endured all for God in his church. She died in Rome in 1380 at the age of 33. Reflection. The seraphic saint Catherine willingly sacrificed the delights of contemplation to labor for the church and apostolic see. How deeply do the troubles of the church and the consequent loss of souls afflict us? How often do we pray for the church and the Pope? On behalf of Saints Fans Association, I wish you all a happy feast. Amen.